Our seven-week observance of Easter culminates with Pentecost, or the day the Holy Spirit was sent from heaven and rested on the apostles, clothing them with power from on high to proclaim the gospel. But aside from simply identifying the Holy Spirit as the third divine person of the Holy Trinity, it is good to keep in mind what we profess. Meaning, the Holy Spirit has always been with, in, and God Himself. During creation, He was the creative force that enabled God's Word to accomplish God's will. He was the same force that made the incarnation of God's Word in Jesus possible in Mary's womb. He was the Spirit that glorified Jesus in His resurrection from the dead. He was the very Spirit that emboldened the apostles to proclaim to all peoples the mighty acts of God in Jesus, giving birth to the church. He is the same Spirit that has been sustaining the church from the day He descended on the apostles until today. He continuously ensures the flow of divine grace, recreating us always to become true witnesses of Christ on earth. But while for the most part we know or recognize the Holy Spirit through His silent and self-effacing ways, it is good to keep in mind that He also came down in the form of fire. What does it mean for the church? Pope Francis teaches us, friends, I encourage you to cultivate a devotion to the Holy Spirit who comes to us as fire. May He make our hearts burn with love and courage to speak the truth. May His purifying fire lead us to a life totally conformed to Christ. May we become agents of the Holy Spirit, the love of the Father and the Son poured in our hearts. Happy Feast Day.